Hey guys. So this month, actually, oh, those are cute. This month actually is the month that I am just taking my time and studying and understanding many ways that I can grow my money. Now, here's the great thing, right? Now, I know how to make money. I know how to keep money. But remember, we also have to grow money, right? So as we go on this journey of entrepreneurship, it's not just about getting money, right? We got to understand the principles of business, okay? We got to understand the principles of money. Yes, we make money through servicing people, through products and services, but then we also got to know how to keep the money, and we got to know how to grow and multiply it. See, it's not about making 10 grand in a month or 50 grand in a month. It's how much of that money can you actually put away for the next 10, 20 years to grow? That's the key to this, guys. So a lot of people work their job for 40 years and have nothing to show for it because they never follow this principle of now growing your money, okay? So what I learned from Warren Buffett just this week, actually yesterday, he was saying that any time is the best time to start investing. He said, people overthink investing. They think it's like this big illuminated thing. You know, it's like, it's just like eating, you know, when is the best time to eat, right? When you're hungry. So again, you know, he said that investing now is the best time. And he said, the earlier that you invest, I mean, of course, the more money. One thing he said about the stock market is that the stock market goes up every time. Every time it falls, it goes back up. This man is 86 years old. He's been studying stocks since he's been 7 years old. So for 80 years, this man's been studying it, right? So I got some audios and books and stuff like that, you know, that I'm watching and listening to, just to get the more confidence of putting, you know, 10, 20, 30 grand in the stock market. So, I mean, again, right? Warren Buffett is the guy, okay, the guy to listen to when you want to invest. But he's not the guy to listen to if you only got $1,000 to invest. It's not going to work, right? If you got 10, 20, 40, 50,000, 100 million, like, this guy knows what he's doing. So what I realize is that when you invest, right, you're looking to get a return. So whether I'm investing in myself, in a course or a training or getting a mentor or going to an event or listening to an audio, you know, buying a class or whatever the case is, right? All of that's considered investing in myself. Okay. All of that is under the umbrella of investing in myself. So it doesn't matter what price I pay. It doesn't matter what price I pay. When you're investing, you're not thinking about the price that you have to pay. You think about the ROI. What is the return on my money? What is the return on my investment? Okay, so some of the pharmaceutical stocks are paying like 8% a year. But if you only put $1,000 in that stock, you only making $80. Is that gonna tickle your fancy? Is that gonna make you, you know, want to, you know, wake up every day only making $80? Now, if you got $10,000 in a stock that's performing at 8%, guess what? Now you're getting like $800. That's more, right? Because now you can compound $800 every year. This is what Warren Buffett said. He said, don't worry about the stock price. Don't worry about if it's volatile. He said, don't worry about if it's going up and down. He said, because if you're investing for the next 10, 20 years anyway, you're going to benefit anyway, right? But if every little move in the market, you get nervous and you get scared. And he said, people that sell their stocks are stupid, right? They don't have enough information. They didn't invest enough money in themselves. They probably watched two YouTube videos or read one book and now they're an expert. No, I'm taking the whole month of April, guys, just to study stocks. Now, I already have Nike stock a little bit. I already got GE stock, and I have some other stock, just a little bit of it. But now I'm on a different level. Now I want to get 5 and 10,000 and 20,000 stocks in a company. And what are stocks, right? Stocks is just basically getting a piece of the business. And, you know, I'm in my econ, and Ivy Stokes said, we need to own a piece of America. We need to own a piece of America. And all these American businesses that are paying dividends every single year on our money, guess what? It's out here. All you need to be is 18 and over, right? To be able to invest. But again, if we didn't learn this, all we did was, okay, say, you know, I'm going to put money in a 401k and hopefully that my 401k performs. And then a lot of people are retiring right now and their 401k is not performing. They fell into the lie. They fell into the lie that the government was going to take care of them. They fell into the lie that their company was going to match whatever they put in. That's not happening. All right, there's a lot of companies that stop that, all right? Even for police and correction officers, they're hiring them at higher pay, but no benefits, no 401k, right? No pensions and all that stuff. So if you don't take responsibility, guys, Ash Cash was talking about this. If you don't take responsibility for your money, okay, you will always wonder what if, and you will always pay high taxes. So you got to take your money seriously, right? Whether you're making 30 grand a year, 50 grand a year, 30 grand a month, you got to take your money seriously. It's not about how much money you're getting. It's about how much money you can actually take and grow, right? Especially black people, we accumulate too much junk, too many belts, too many shoes, too many wigs, too many cars, you know, too many pots, too many pans. That's worthless, right? All that stuff that we have in our homes, right, that we accumulated over 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years, and it amounts to zero. So investing is a long-term 10-plus year play. So in order for you and me, right, to understand that, we have to study it and we got to take our money seriously. I watch my bank account all the time. I watch my money all the time. I don't have a financial advisor watching my money for me. And I learned that from Grant Cardone. He said, don't have nobody else watching your money. Watch your own money. Now, you may have people assist you. Like, I have an app that assists me, and I also have a CPA that assists me. But no, I'm not turning my money over to a perfect stranger. This is what employees are doing. They turn their money every month to a perfect stranger who don't like them, who don't care about them. And then hopefully everything works out when it's time for them to retire. And it never does. So again, whether you're 25, whether you're 15, whether you're 55, if you don't pay attention to your money now, guess what? You will never pay attention to your money, right? See, one of the things that money is, money gives us a peace of mind. Money allows us to live the life that we want. Money is like brushing your teeth. Money is like washing your ass. You going to tell somebody else to take care of washing your ass? You going to tell somebody else to take care of brushing your teeth every morning? No. So every morning, don't you brush your teeth? Every morning, don't you look in the mirror and, you know, say, let me brush my teeth? Or if you got a cavity, don't you go to the dentist? You don't rely on people to do that? When it's time to wash your ass, do you say, well, let me just take my ass and send it to somebody and let them wash and hopefully it comes back clean? No, you don't. So you got to think of your money as brushing your teeth, as a daily thing, as a daily health thing, because money is health. Having no money causes major health issues. Having some money, okay, allows your health to be better. Money is a part of our hearts. Money is a part of our souls, for real, okay? Money is a part of our thoughts. So that's health. And if you just say, I'm going to just send my ass off, or I'm going to send my mouth off to somebody and they going to brush it for me or take care of it. No, they're not. So we got to take care of our money, right? We got to take care of our money. Sitting in the bank is not the way to take care of your money. Stocks, bonds, ETFs, real estate, gold, silver, oil, and businesses. This is the way to grow our money. You can't do all eight. So you got to find one that's going to grow your money. Okay? Whether you're investing in someone's business, like a laundromat, and you're putting $5,000-$10,000 up, right, as an investor, right? Think about Shark Tank. They always say, what's the return on my money? If I give you $100 million, you know what I'm saying? If I give you, $100,000, I want, 20% on my money. Right? That's exactly what they're saying. I want 20% on my money. Right? So again, are you taking care of your money? Or are you sending it off to Wall Street, hoping that Wall Street is going to take care of your money? Or are you going to say, I'm going to take care of my money because I have no choice? I don't want somebody trying to brush my teeth. I don't want somebody trying to wash my ass. I need to wash my own ass. Okay, I need to wash my own ass and I need to brush my own teeth. So that same thing, I need to take care of my own money. I need to take care of my own money. I need to take care of my own future. I need to take care of my own retirement account. That's what I need to do. Okay, so every day when you wake up, guys, you should have a plan on how to get your bank account to basically where you want to be at. Extra $100 a day, $200 a day, $750 a day, $1,500 a day, whatever it is. Your bank account should be growing every day. And then you take that money and then you put it somewhere so it can passively grow. Right? We got earned income where you work for it. We got passive income where you don't work for it. Then you have royalties from like books and businesses. Right? And then you got equity income that accumulates over time in your home. And that's a part of your net worth, right? So earned income, passive income, royalty income, equity, income, commission income, okay? And profits, from a business. So again, if you're just working on earned income, you can never get rich. You have to earn income so that you can put it into a vehicle that's passive income. I met this guy, 23 years old, millionaire. And he said his father, at 7 years old, put up 50,000. No, he said not 50,000. I think he said 25,000 or 20,000 in a stock, a performing stock that was getting like 4% a year. And he said his father just kept reinvesting. He said by the time he was 18 years old, he had like $4 million. And at the end of the day, his dad, told him, this is your money. You can either keep reinvesting the money or do whatever you want. He said he didn't go to college. You know what I'm saying? He finished high school. And he said all he's doing now is continuing to study this stuff. Because $4 million from something that his dad did from him once, and when he was 7 and he's 23, so now he has to pass the torch to his children if he decides to have children. So now what he's doing is gaining the knowledge. So he's taking the time to understand his money, where his money's going, what he's doing with his money. He's not saying, oh, here you go, Wall Street. You can have my money. You can do whatever you want to do with it. I trust you. No, I don't trust nobody with my fucking money. I don't give a fuck. I don't trust nobody with my money, right? So Warren Buffett said, now is the best time to invest. The markets will go down, but they always go up. Number one rule of investing, never lose money, right? Never lose money, right? The second rule is remember rule number one. So again, right? We can live on a hope. We can live on this wish. We can live on this prayer, right? But if you never take responsibility, guys, for your money, you will always wonder what if. You will always be saying, I got to make more money. Because if you can't manage the $1,000 that you got now, or the $5,000 you got now, or even the $100 that you got now, making more money won't make a difference for you. So that's why financial literacy is so key. That's why I got my Black Wealth class. You pay $20 a month, learn something new. That's why I got my Amazon class. You're investing. When you start a business, you're investing. It's not the price. It's the return. Can you get 30% on your money? Can you get 10% on your money? Can you get 50% on your money in the next 6 months or the next year or the next 3 years? That's how you become a boss. Not worried about, oh, I don't got 500. Oh, I don't got 1,500. Oh, I don't got 3,000. What's the return, though, on the investment? That's why wealthy people keep getting wealthier. Rich people just keep getting rich, guys, because they are willing to learn. They are willing to keep investing in themselves to get a return in the future. The future could be a month from now, a year from now, 10 years from now, but they're willing to do it. Broke people don't. Wealthy people, rich people make money with their kids. Broke people do not. So again, which side of the spectrum are you going to be on? Are you going to start paying attention to your money? Are you going to take your money out of your 401k and all that other bullshit that's not helping you and start understanding and managing your own money and understanding how not to pay taxes? Right? Because if all you do is earn money, then you will always pay taxes for the rest of your life. Robert Kiyosaki said he finds every loophole where he don't have to pay taxes. He's finding every loophole that he don't have to pay taxes. So if this dividend brings him in $1 million a year, and they say, okay, with this dividend, you can actually put it into a nonprofit, or you can put it into some real estate, or you can reinvest it, you don't got to pay taxes, that's exactly what he's going to do. Right? And I'm just following what he's saying. I'm just following what he's doing. And look at Warren Buffett, 86. Charlie Munger is like 90 years old. Robert Kiyosaki's over 70. Right? So wealth happens, right, after you build and build and build over the years, then you become wealthy. Right? You get rich. You could get rich in your 20s and 30s, but wealth, even Grant, didn't get wealthy till he's 50. Right? But what are you working on? What are you building towards every single day that's going to get you the wealth, the legacy that you are working towards? If it's just working a job, you're never going to build nothing. That's why everyone needs a business. This is why everyone needs a business. That's why everyone needs a business. You got your earned income from your job. You take your job money, start you a business, start getting profits, and then start growing that stuff. But again, you know, people need coaches, people need mentors, and they don't want to invest in themselves to get it. So again, I only can help those who saying, you know what, Tanisha, you're right. I want to do what you're saying. I want to move forward, you know, with my life. I want to start me a business. I want to, you know, experience passive income. I'm tired of working for money. Money is dying. At the speed of light, money done lost 93% of its value in the last 10 years, and people are working even harder. People are working overtime just to pay more taxes, and taxes is going up. So if you never learn principles and skills, guys, that can help your money grow, you're going to work until you die. If that doesn't scare you, guys, I don't know. I don't want to work until I'm dead. I don't want to work until I'm 85 or 75 years old. I want to live my life. I want to travel. I want to go where I want to go. I want to do what I want to do. Wake up when I'm done sleeping. Go to sleep when I'm tired. Right? Wherever I want to do. I don't want to work until I'm died. No. Unless I love doing what I'm doing. Yeah. That's different. Warren Buffett. Bill Gates, they still work. They work 7 days a week, but they love doing it. They love running their business. They love looking at numbers. They love creating products. But if you at a supermarket, that's a dead-end job. You a social worker, that's a dead-end job, right? Okay? You a police officer, that's a hard dead-end job. Okay? You doing that for what? You 85 years old, a police officer? A hairstylist is a dead-end career unless you're going to franchise your business out. If you're not going to franchise it, your hairstylist career is a dead-end career because you got to do it until you're 55, 65, 75. A mechanic is a dead-end career. A lawyer is a dead-end career. Okay, a judge is a dead-end career if you're not taking your money and growing it. I can't help everybody. Only can help those who's willing to listen. How can you help those who's willing to go? I'm only help those who's willing, you know, you are not on my... I can only help those guys who's willing to listen. I can only help those who's saying, you're right, Tanisha. I need to do some shit, and I need to do some shit now. It's 2019, guys. 2020. 2025. 2030 is around the corner. What you gonna say? You still gonna be doing the same nothing? I hope not. So go to createmyowneconomy.com. Watch my Amazon webinar. Invest in yourself so that you can get an ROI, so that you can start growing your money. This is how it works. Period. See you guys soon.